optical activity.
Some of the organic molecules will rotate the plane polarized light either towards the left side or towards the right side, and that particular ability of organic molecules is taken as reference for the optical activity. So therefore, to possess optical activity, they should do the rotation of the plane polarized light from its original direction when it is allowed to pass through them. Thus, molecules, especially in case of organic chemistry, organic molecules which can rotate the plane polarized light are said to be optically active molecules. Organic molecules which can rotate plane polarized light either towards left or right are known as optically active molecules. Molecules which can rotate the plane polarized light either towards the left side or towards the right side, or in any sides where the plane polarized light is propagating to that direction, if plane polarized light deviates from its original path, either it may be shifted towards the left side or it may be shifted towards the right side, then those molecules which are responsible for shifting of the direction of the plane polarized light, and they are eligible to shift the direction of the plane polarized light either towards the left side or towards the right side, such kind of organic molecules are said to be optically active molecules. Whereas for this optical activity, symmetry is responsible. Whereas if the molecule is not having symmetry, then molecules are said to be dissymmetric molecules. If molecule is having dissymmetry, then molecule is having ability to rotate the plane polarized light, to shift the direction of the expected direction of the plane polarized light, and those of all molecules are known as optically active molecules. So in order to understand the optical activity, we should know the symmetry. Symmetry present in the molecule, that is symmetric molecule, and what is meant by dissymmetric molecule. When a molecule is able to show optical activity, before the symmetry elements, we should know how to represent the organic molecules, because organic molecules are carbon containing molecules, and everywhere carbon is connected with the four valencies, and these four valencies are present in the three dimensional space. Thus, whatever the three dimensional space is occupied by the valencies of the carbon, those are to be represented either on the board or on the paper on two dimensions. Then how a three dimensional is generally represented on the two dimensions, how properly a three dimensional structure of a molecule of organic compound is represented on the two dimensions, first we learn these representations, then we will go for the symmetry elements, then we will come for the discussion that which symmetry elements options is compulsory to make a given organic compound as optically active compound, thereby how many symmetry elements are there, which are active, which are non-active, and how many varieties are there, what are the relations. These are all things in detail, step by step we will discuss. The first our task of discussion is representation of organic molecule. How many varieties of representations are there, and how they are interconvertible, and why one particular representation is more familiar compared to the other. While going for the mechanism, which particular representation helps us a lot, and from the representation, how can we assume the symmetry elements present in it, and what are its corresponding categories. Let us have a detailed explanation related to the optical isomerism of the molecules. Yes, we can divide the organic molecules on behalf of symmetry into two categories. As a conclusion of the discussion, elongated discussion that we had made on the optical activity, yes, organic molecules having some special characteristic elements, special characteristic properties, are able to rotate the plane polarized light. Thus, organic molecules are divided into two categories, molecules having no symmetry and molecules having symmetry. And molecules whichever are having symmetry are known as symmetric molecules, and molecules those which are not having any kind of symmetry elements are said to be asymmetric molecules. Symmetric molecules are optically inactive molecules, and technically the word used to say the symmetric molecules are the optically inactive molecules is achiral molecule, whereas molecules which are not having symmetry elements are said to be asymmetric molecules, and asymmetric molecules are also known as what? Chiral molecules. Chiral stands for what? Optically active molecules. There are many symmetry elements, but certain symmetry elements are the deciding elements. Those symmetries are plane of symmetry, center of symmetry, and alternate axis of symmetry. These symmetry elements are taken as reference symmetry elements. If these are absent, then the molecule is known as asymmetric molecule, and asymmetric molecule is optically active molecule, and every optically active molecule is said to be chiral molecule. So therefore, those symmetry elements whichever are there, those are generally to decide the optical activity. Those are three. First one is plane of symmetry, second one is center of symmetry, and third one is alternate axis of symmetry. We will explain what is meant by these of all things. When these three are absent, then the molecule is known as symmetric molecule. When these three are absent, then the molecule is known as asymmetric molecule, that is optical active and chiral. If any one of them is present, then molecule is optically inactive, that is known as symmetric molecule. Technically it is known as chiral molecule. Then we will explain what is meant by plane of symmetry, when we have to go for center of symmetry, when we have to go for alternate axis of symmetry, which molecules are optically active, which molecules are optically inactive. These are all things we will discuss. And we will discuss how to measure the optical activity, what is optical rotation, what is specific rotation, and what are the factors affecting on the specific rotation, what are the factors affecting on the rotation associated with the optically active chiral molecule. All things in detail we will discuss. And the first topic of discussion is representation of organic molecule and mode of representation of organic molecules. Yes, representation of organic molecules. What is a special cause to represent the organic molecule? What is the mode of representation of organic molecule? And why we have to represent in a special manner? And logically, we have to use our brain to understand the structure of molecule. Why we have to do the extra work is, yes, organic molecule is three-dimensional. If I take a carbon atom, carbon is, in case of organic molecule, in majority of the cases, carbon is connected with four valences. These four valences are present in the three-dimensional space, and they are occupying the total available three-dimensional space around the carbon atom. The angle present between the carbon atoms, if it is regular sp3 hybridization, 109 degrees 28 minutes, such kind of features are there. Whereas we have to represent this particular three-dimensionally adjusted valences of the carbon in two dimension, because where we are writing the structure on paper, on board, on two dimensions. So here total five things are there: carbon and carbon connected with the other four valences. If I feel every valency is an atom, five valencies, that is five atoms are there. Out of five atoms present in the simplest example of simple carbon connected with the five different atoms, five different valencies, these are occupying the three-dimensional space, but I have to represent this one in two-dimension. So therefore, the best way of two-dimensional representation is maximum atoms along with the central atom I can keep on the plane, and remaining atoms, some of them are present away from the plane, some of them are present towards us away from the plane. So therefore, how the representation is present, how they are going to be represented, how technically we will represent those connectivities associated with the reference carbon atom, as some of them are present towards us, some of them are present away from us, how technically we will represent, what the sense that we can get from the representation, how everybody can write the unique structure. These of all things are involved in this representation. That's what to represent properly, otherwise to properly represent the organic molecule on two dimensional plane or two dimensional paper or board, here the three dimensional molecule is represented with some logics, with some interpretations, with some ideology behind it, whereas every particular representation becomes very easy. To do that one, we are representing the molecules, that's what we are going for the representation. The best way, thus here we can represent in many number of ways.
Yes.
Always that carbon atom which is expected at the center can be written on the board, followed by out of four valencies it is having. Out of four valencies, here no valency can be kept on the plane. No valency can be kept on the plane. I can keep in such a way that carbon can be just present on the plane followed by all other ways. Carbon followed by one valency on the plane followed by remaining. Otherwise carbon followed by two valencies on the plane followed by remaining. How they can be adjusted. Carbon followed by, yes, if I don't keep the carbon, three valencies on the plane. Carbon followed by one of the valency away from the plane. Thus, a particular single carbon associated with four valencies can be represented in many number of ways. Then in representation, two things are very clear. That is, one valency, otherwise one particular expected connectivity can be presented towards us. And another particular connectivity can be present away from us. Then how to distinguish? And some of the valencies are just present on the plane, that is on the board. Then how to represent that? Thus, to give a special way of representation, a special way of presentation was given for those things which are towards us, which are away from us, which are on the paper, which are on the board. Thus, different ways of representation scheme. We are going for the first way of representation, that is said to be flying wedge representation. This is the simplest way of representation of the organic molecules. In a systematic, stylish way, we represent some of the valencies. By its representation, we can feel that this valency is present on the paper. This valency is present away from the paper. And that away from the paper is either towards us or away from us. Thus, every particular way of representation of a bond is having its own meaning. That way of representation is said to be the flying wedge representation. Yes, in flying wedge representation, the valencies which are connected with the reference carbon atom are written in such a way that some of them are written with the just normal lines. Those indicates that those connectivities are just present on the two-dimensional part. Whereas some of them are written with the dark lines, some of them are written with the dotted lines. The meaning of that one is whichever are written with the darker lines, those are towards us from the board. Whereas those whichever are written dark dotted, those are far away from us from the board. That is the meaning. You feel it is a transparent system. Whereas some of the valencies are written dark. Dark indicates that that connectivity is projecting towards us. We are looking that one that is facing towards us. We are taking carbon as the reference. Carbon is present on the two-dimensional plane. Suppose if I go for the simplest system, that is carbon connected with four valencies, and this can be present in such a way that valencies towards us, we can adjust. One of the way of adjustment is one carbon, that is reference carbon atom, is expected to be present on the plane, followed by, yes, one is towards us, followed by remaining two remaining three valencies away from us. I can adjust like this. Else I can adjust that two are towards us, two are away from us. I can adjust that three are towards us, followed by one is away from us. Suppose if I go for the corresponding presentation. Number one, what we are expecting, this is the carbon. And out of this carbon connected with four valencies, valencies towards us only one. So we are expecting one bond is like this. One valency is projecting towards us, it is facing towards us like this. And remaining three are present away from us like this. This is one way of representation. Second one way of representation is, two are present away towards us and remaining two are present away from us. In this way also we can represent. In the last case, in this, three are towards us. Yes, we can keep maximum three are towards us and another one is present away from us. Thus, One carbon related four connected valencies or bonds or the groups or the atoms can be represented in one of the way in such a way that carbon atom is present on the plane followed by one is towards us, three are away, two are towards us, two are away, and three are towards us, one is away. In this way we can represent, this is one way of representation, but this way will become not a useful way, because here what happens is we are not taking the help of board much. We are taking a little help of the board. So if I keep the maximum valencies on the board along with the carbon, then the remaining valencies I can take the three-dimensional space help, and in that also I can use the most of the space, that is space present towards me, towards us and away from us. Then that way of representation will give the best way of representation. This is one. We will go for the next one. Yes, the second way of representation, carbon and one valency is expected to be present on plane followed by remaining three are adjusted in such a way that they are not on the plane. One is on the plane in such a way that is projecting towards us, remaining two are away from us, and vice versa case can also be present. Out of four valencies, here carbon followed by one of the valencies is expected to be present on the plane. And remaining three, out of three, one is towards us. So therefore one valency is present towards us, and what about the fate of remaining two valencies? These are away from us. And the second case, reverse of this one, one valency is on the plane followed by two are towards us, this is first one and this is second one, whereas the remaining one is away from us. In this way also we can represent the system. This is one way, that is one is carbon followed by one of the valencies on the plane. Remaining things can be adjusted in all possible ways. In this way also the carbon connected valencies can be represented. But this is also not the most suitable way, because here one valency is represented on the plane where we will feel most convenient, that is the plane. On the plane we are expecting minimum valencies only. We can enhance another one valency also. Let us go for that one also. Yes, in this way of representation, one carbon followed by two valencies on the plane and remaining two are adjusted in such a way that those are present in such a way that one is towards us and one is away from us. In this way we can represent the system. Thus, in different ways of flying waste representation of a simple carbon connected with valencies like 1, 2, 3, 4 randomly. Here I am feeling this is 1, 2, 3, 4, valency 1, valency 2, valency 3, valency 4, valency 1, valency 2, valency 3 and valency 4. In first way, I can feel only just this carbon atom is present on the plane, remaining all things are present in all possible varieties. Some of them are towards us, some of them are away from us. And in the second case, carbon followed by one of the valencies is expected to be present in the plane. Remaining they are adjusted in such a way that one can be towards, two can be towards, like that cases. In the last, another possible case, carbon followed by two connected valencies are expected on the plane and remaining valencies are present away from the plane, otherwise not on the plane, in such a way that one is towards us and one is away from us. Thus, these are the major three possible varieties of representation of a molecule in flying birds representation. Whereas while writing the flying birds representation for one carbon atom, you feel these many varieties of cases. Suppose if I am having an organic molecule and it is present in the zigzag representation, majority of the zigzag representation of extended connectivities towards the left and right are generally written on the board followed by the valencies. Suppose this is one valency and this is one valency, this is one valency, this is one valency, this is one valency and other valencies. That is in this way of representation, carbon followed by the two valencies which are written on the paper followed by remaining two valencies are not on the paper, not on the paper, in such a way that one of them is towards us and other of them is away from us. This way of representation is normally occurs in case of wedge representation of organic molecules. Yes, as we know, the stereoisomerism whereas the connectivities remain same, spatial arrangement of connectivities, if it differs, then it gives isomer related to the compounds. Thus, representation in wedge followed by proper representation in wedge is also very, very important. Thus, how a wedge structure can be viewed in many number of ways. Let us go for one example, thereby it becomes very clear enough. And that is flying wedge representation types and the varieties. If I go for the first one, where what I am expecting is just carbon is present on the plane followed by all valencies are adjusted, not on the plane. So therefore, out of them, the case number one is present towards us and remaining three are present away from us. If I feel that way of representation, carbon is present on the plane followed by one valency is towards us, second valency away from us, third valency and the fourth valency all are away from us, then this is molecule represented in the wedge. I am feeling that those valencies with the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And this particular way can be represented, then why one should be present towards us, I can keep in the place of one other things, then how it can change this and how this particular molecule can be viewed in many number of ways is an issue. Suppose if I want to view by keeping one on the plane, yes, I can interchange these 2, 3, 4 in such a way that the minimum 2 changes. Suppose 2 and 3 are changed. This is count for 1. Similarly here, whatever comes, this one and this one is changed. 2 interchanges of the valencies results the same compound. So therefore, though connectivity remains same, here connectivity remains same, if you change 1, then spatial orientation differs. But if you change even interchanges, though it may involve the repetition of involved valency, then it represents or it gives the same compound. Suppose if I want to give the same compound with the another one, I am keeping one as it is. If I change in the place of 2 with the 3, so therefore this will becomes equal to 3 here. Now here it will becomes equal to what? 2. And this will becomes equal to 4. But here to here only one change was occurred. One change in place, it will become isomer if possibility is there. To maintain even changes, once again I am involving these two groups, so therefore this is 4 and this is 2. Even changes of the groups, though they may involve the repetition more than one times if they reoccur in the interchange once, so therefore that case it results the same compound. This compound and this compound appears to be differed on the board, but these are same, there is no difference in the connectivities. We are maintaining connectivity everywhere same, followed by this kind of spatial adjustment and this kind of spatial adjustment, both results the same. Hence, these two compounds are said to be the same compounds. Similarly, here I can keep any one of them as constant. I can involve remaining three in such a way that two times, that is exchange one followed by exchange two, if happens, then that results the same compound. I want to change at this position, I want to replace this one by some other group. I want to keep 4 here, otherwise 3 here, then what will happen? If I want to keep 3 here, I am expecting that the valency 3 is present towards me. Then in the place of 3, 1 will come, but that will become how many exchanges? 1 exchanges. To maintain the same here, you keep the structure as it is. To maintain the same, you change here 2 and 4. So therefore, this structure, all are same. There is no difference in the structures. There is no the difference in the three-dimensional adjustment of connectivities around the carbon atom. Thus, always you remember that even exchanges around a wedge representation, flying wedge representation, even exchange of the valencies results the same compound. Though that may be case number one, just carbon is present on the plane. Case number two, carbon followed by one valency is expected to be present on the plane. Case number 3, carbon followed by 2 valencies present on the plane. Everywhere you remember that even exchanges of the groups results the same compound without any difference in the three-dimensional orientation of connectivities associated with the carbon atom. Yes, if I apply the rules for the case number 3, that is carbon followed by 2 valencies on the plane, if I want to expect that 3 and 4 are present on the plane, then I have to write the same structure as it is. I don't want to change any kind of connectivities. Connectivities relationship has to be maintained as it is. I want to look at that 3 and 4 should be present on the plane. Yes, replace 1 with 3. Whereas this will become 1, that is one exchange, odd number of exchanges. replace 4 with 2. So therefore, here in this picture, instead of 1 and 2, 3 and 4 are expected to be present on the plane, followed by 1 and 2, whichever are present on the plane, now become away, that is not on the plane, that is one is present towards us, one is present away from us, this structure and this structure is same. Because always even exchanges with repetition or without repetition results the same structure, there won't be any kind of difference. I can keep one of them as non-involved in the interchange and remaining three valencies you can take it as a set of two interchanges in such a way that one is repeated, then also it results the same compound. Similarly, you can involve all the atoms at once and you will get the other connectivities, you will get the another way of representation that is also resembles the same structure. You remember that in flying wedge representation, by involving all atoms even exchanges or by keeping some atom constant followed by remaining atoms even exchanges always results the same compound. Thus here this structure and this structure remains the same. Thus just carbon on the plane, carbon followed by one valency on the plane, carbon followed by two valencies on the plane, in every case either by involving all atoms or by involving repetition of the atom, even exchanges always results the same compound, whereas odd exchanges results the isomer of the compounds. That's what a proper representation and interconversion of representation is also very very important in case of flying wedge representation. Yes, flying wedge interconversion from one structure to other structure, whereas a structure is carbon followed by two valencies are present on the plane, we have to convert this one to just carbon present on the plane. Suppose carbon followed by two valencies, valency 1 followed by valency 2 is present on the plane, whereas here I am having some valency away from us and one valency towards us in such a way that this is valency 3 and valency 4. Now I want to convert this one to another way of wedge representation where just carbon is expected to be present on the plane. And now if you visualize this one, this is present in such a way that these two connectivities and the carbon are present on the plane. If it is the plane just like this, what about 3? 3 is present like this towards us, whereas this fourth one is present away from us, this is present back side of the port. If I write this one in such a way that if I want to keep this particular just carbon on the plane, if I pick up this carbon away from the board towards us in such a way, then 1 will become away from the board and 2 will become away from the board. Then whichever is present on the present in the structure 1, that is towards us followed by away from us, they will become towards us. See here, if I take this one up, then this particular towards us and away from us both are comes in such a way that close to towards the observer, and that appears in such a way that see this valency 1 is present away from us. Similarly, valency 2 is also present away from us. This is the fate of 1 and 2. Whereas valency 3 remains as it is and valency 4 also remains as it is. This will become valency 3 and this will become valency 4. This is valency 3 and this will become as valency 4. Thus, in that way, if any wedge presentation of 2 present on the plane, 1 is away from the plane towards us and 1 is away from the plane, away from us is present, then that one can be represented in such a way that yes, those board valencies can be written away from us, that is away from us at the top, away from us at the bottom, this is away from us at the top, away from us at bottom, followed by remaining two things can be adjusted towards us in such a way that this particular valency 3 is present towards us, towards the left, towards us, towards the right. In this way we can represent these two structures are same and equal to one another. And and you know that you can interchange any of the things from here, any of the things from here, you can interchange these two followed by these two, these two followed by these two, 1-2 combination, 1-3 combination, 1-4 combination with the other, all other permutations and combinations works. Thus whichever valency you want to keep at the top, at the bottom, away from us, towards left, right, at all positions, wherever you want, you can keep the groups. Thus, everything is allowed. Thus, what we are doing is, we are keeping these two things away from us like this. As a result, these two will come towards the observer from the board. So therefore, this is present towards the, because it is from the beginning, it is present towards us. It will be tilted like this. So it will come towards the left and this one will go towards the right side. Yes, here I am having a compound in the wedge presentation, whereas the first way of representation, just carbon is present on the plane followed by four valences are present in such a way, four are different, followed by one and two are present away from us, that is away from the board in such a way that is away top and away bottom, and three and four are present towards me, towards us, towards right and towards left to us. Whereas this structure can be represented in different varieties. I wrote the similar structure of the same one, whereas I interchanged 1 and 2 here. If I interchanged 1 and 2, this is one interchange, odd interchanges, to make it as same, even interchanges has to be made. So therefore, this structure and this structure are same. Here I made interchange of 1 and 3, 1 is changed with 3, similarly 2 is exchanged with the 4. Similarly, 1 and 4, once again this 1 and 4 in place, 2 and 3, 1 and 4, so therefore this is 2 and 3, so this will be 3 and this will be 2, so these 4 structures are same to one another. Now you are expected to write the other isomer of this molecular formula, whereas from this 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, whichever is there, I am expecting the other isomer, possible other isomer, and its corresponding this way of structural presentation of the other isomer for the molecule. As a conclusory part towards the wedge representation, we can feel that one form can be represented in many number of ways. One form can be converted into the other form. While writing the structure of one form in many number of ways, the basic rule that has to be remembered is always even exchanges results the same compound, like two exchanges, four exchanges, etc. They may involve repetition also. Repetition stands for not the repetition of the total involved atoms, one atom repetition. Whereas odd exchanges always results the isomeric compound. And always you remember in wedge representation, the dark bond always represents the valency connected to the carbon is towards us. And the dotted bond always represents the valency connected to the carbon is away from us. These are the rules. Once again, to your notice, one form can be converted to other form. And one form can be represented in many number of ways. Whereas in representation of one form in many number of ways, yes, many number of ways comes by replacing one group by the other group. The rule has to be followed is always even exchanges results the same compound. Whereas if you do the odd exchanges results the isomeric compounds. You remember one thing, that is whichever normal line is there, normal line is that is on the plane. If I write the normal line, that is on plane, whichever valency or connectivity is present on the plane, that is written with the normal line. Whichever atom is there in the normal board, that is written just like an atom. Whereas whichever the connectivity is present towards us, that is written with the dark line. Whichever connectivity is present away from us, that is written with the dotted line. Remaining all normal valencies and the atoms which are present on the board are written with the normal line. Atom is generally written as atom. These are the rules and the conclusions related to the wedge presentation. Now we will go for certain molecules and you are expected to write the corresponding same structure and the isomeric structure of the molecules. Yes, dear students, here I have an example, that is amino acid, that is 2-methyl amino acid, 2-methyl amino acid, 2-aminopropionic acid, not 2-methyl, 2-aminopropionic acid, 2-aminopropionic acid. This is one of the 2-aminopropionic acid. I have two structures for the 2-aminopropionic acids, two different molecules are there. This is one of the molecule and its corresponding structure is written over there. Then you are asked to write the corresponding whatever the given formula, given isomer of the, given one isomer of the 2-aminopropionic acid which you are represented on the board. You are asked to write that one in the Fischer presentation of type 1 by keeping just carbon on the plane. You write the structure, central atom. type 2 carbon followed by one of the valency on the plane followed by remaining are away from the plane, all varieties are there. Carbon followed by two valencies, whichever is written, carbon followed by two valencies on the plane followed by remaining two are not on the plane, followed by all possible interconversions, that carbon followed by remaining other varieties. One valency can be valency 1, valency 2, valency 3. This may be 1 and 2 combination, 1 3 combination, 1 4 combination, 2 1 combination, that is 2 3 combination, 2 4 combination, like this. I am expecting that 1 and 2 is here, 1 3 combination, 1 4 combination, 2 3 combination, 2 4 combination, 3 4 combination, like this. I am expecting you to write all possible varieties related to this particular presentation. And next one is interconversion of the structure 1, any one of the structure from structure 1, type 1, one of the structure from type 2, one of the structure from type 3, you keep as it is and you say the rules related to the interconversion, you follow the rules, you follow the plane to the non-planar rules also, and you write, you say correct, you say that the structure 1, type 1 of any one structure, type 2 of any one structure, type 3 of any one structure are same. With this conclusion, I can change the type 1 structure to type 2, type 2 structure to type 3 for this particular molecule as homework. And another one question as homework for you for this particular 2 carbons consisting valencies, like 3 different valencies at the first carbon atom, another 3 valencies, by keeping the carbon-carbon connectivity as same and constant, you are expected to write all possible other wedge representations of the molecule, like at the place of 1 I am expecting 2, at the place of 2 I am expecting 3, similarly at the place of suppose 7 is there, I want to get 6 here, I want to get 5 here, thus by keeping these of all constant, how many varieties of other fissures, other wedge presentations are there at the second site, this is second site, this is first site. Similarly, by keeping these of all constant, suppose if I feel 1 and 5, similarly here 1 and 6, here 1 and 7, at the place of 1, 2, 2 and 5, 2 and 6, 2 and 7, 3 and 5, 3 and 6, 3 and 7, like all possible other varieties of the wedge representations of these two chiral carbons containing systems are expected from you in the form of homework. A special homework for those students who are aware of the Fischer presentation here. One chiral carbon is written with associated with the four valencies. I wrote all possible Fischer varieties, like by keeping just carbon on the plane, first model, carbon followed by one valency on the plane followed by one is projecting towards us, two are away, two are projecting towards us, one is away, followed by two are on the plane along with the carbon, remaining two, one is away and one is towards. Thus all varieties of permutations and combinations of different models and their corresponding different varieties, that one valency is present towards the left ear, towards left ear, and here two are top, two are left, two are bottom, like that most of them are written. Now you are asked to identify how many of them are similar structures, how many of them are same structures, and out of 8 structures you are expected to identify same structures of type 1, same structures of type 2, and which are different from one. These are not same. This is structure 1. I am having two varieties of structures. Two structures are possible. How many of them are equal to structure 1? How many of them are equal to structure 2? Whereas those two are different from one another. Yes, structure 1 and structure 2 are same or not. Structure 1 and structure 3 are same or different. Like that, set of structures which are having same of the different Fischer representations, structure 1, what are those? Structure 2, what are those? You are asked to write a list of the compounds.